So as part of our double tank configuration, I want to take just a second and talk about our regulator configuration. As you can see with this set of doubles, we have two individual first stages, allowing us to be able to have gas coming out of this valve to this first stage, gas coming out of this valve to this first stage. I can shut off the gas flowing to this first stage, what we call our left first stage, or I can turn it off here, stopping the gas flow to the right first stage. In the middle is an isolator valve. This would allow me to isolate the tanks individually. We always keep this open. Unless we had a problem with the manifold leaking, then we could isolate it and reserve our gas. When you take technical diving classes, you'll learn all about the amount of gas that we use in reserve and the third rules and things of that nature. So we won't talk about that. But what I do want to show you is you can see how nice and clean this configuration is. This is the brand new Scuba Pro Mark 19 diaphragm. So they configure beautifully. So because we've added the swivel of the Mark 25, we have the ability to have this import. So on my left post, left meaning it's on my left when it's on my back, I have my pressure gauge. In this case, I also have a dry suit hose. And I have my necklace regulator, which is going to come out of the import and set right here below my neck. So when you're technical diving, instead of having an open water configuration where you have one first stage and two second stages, in case you had an issue with something with the one first stage, you could go to the other or you could donate gas. In this case, we still have two second stages, but they're on their own first stage. So I can truly isolate them. If I had a free flow, if I had a hose blow, if I had any kind of problems, I can shut this off, still breathe off of this, and have all the gas I need to be able to get out of the wreck or the cave or wherever I'm at. On my right-hand post, I have, coming out of the import, my low-pressure inflator hose, and I have my 7-foot long hose. So this allows me, again, to be able to have two second stages, two first stages, to be able to completely isolate them. But what's really neat is the fact that with the entire S-Tech configuration and our new Mark 19s, just like our Mark 25s, we have the ability to have an extremely clean manifold configuration here with our double regulators. And when the air is going through the wing, you don't have any kind of hoses that are trapping the gas flow. You don't have anything impinging on the hoses and the movement in the diver's mouth if you're breathing your necklace. It's just really streamlined and clean when the diver's wearing this. Okay, so great setup, and this is the utilization of the Scuba Pro regulators with a double tank configuration. So as you can see, when a set of double tanks are banded together, the top band starts right where the crown meets the flat side of the cylinder. So the cylinder's rounded, it comes down, it's flat. That's where the very top edge goes. In the center of this band is your stainless steel bolt, and the holes should be exactly 11 inches away. So with these being 11 inches away, this makes it very simple for us to make the grommets on our wings and the holes in the center of our back plate to be on that 11 inch centers. So if you're a tall person, a short person, it doesn't really matter. If you're using proper size cylinders for your height and your size, this is going to make sure that you have everything evenly spaced without having any need to go up or down with your back plate or wing. Generally, the need to go up and down is something that can be fixed with trim and training. All right, so we're going to add the stainless steel plate onto our bolts protruding through the wing. And here's where we're able to take advantage of our ergo nut. So we have the strength of the stainless steel wing nut going on the stainless steel bolt. And then we have the convenience of having the large surface area of the ergo nut going into the sockets that have been pressed into our back plate. So large surface area allows me to really tighten this down. You'll be able to hear the squeak of the O-ring against the stainless. And due to the size and thickness of the ergo nut, I can really get a good tightening of both of these. So now we have the bands attached to the doubles. They're tightened together with the bolts. The bolts protrude through the wing. The bolts go through the stainless steel plate. And now the ergo nuts with the stainless steel wing nuts lock everything together, so there's no chance of any slippage of the wing, any separation of the components. This is all locked together for an extremely stable configuration, making your technical diving as safe as possible with the beautiful S-Tech configuration.